Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Gurur Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Assuming that you have all acquired the fourfold spiritual wealth. Now you are wealthy. Viveka Vairagya Shamadi Shataka Sampatti Mumukshitvam Chaiti. These four principles you have in sufficient measure. Good. Now what? See, like many people say, Swamiji, when will I have the vision of God? So I tell them, I say, okay, imagine I am God. Now you have my vision. What next? What will you do thereafter? See? Therefore, we have to have the basics clear. Our life has three components. Yesterday I made a small running reference. One is the world called as anti-bhautik. When we take this world as real and when we take ourselves to be the body, first. Second is we take our experiences as real. I am miserable, I am happy, it is so painful. Being the cat crosses the road. Once we are going somewhere, Swamiji, billi kaat gayi, ab kya hoga? I said, yes, that's my question. What will happen to that billi because of you? See? So we are lost in our experiences. These are the two things, world and experiences of the world. Now the question is, who is experiencing? So these three factors are technically called as Adi Bhautik world, Adi Daivik experiences, Adhyatmik the experiencer. Till such time we give importance and value to this world, we have to follow Dharma Shastra. Satyam Vada Dharmam Chara Swadhyaya Anma Pramadaha Acharyaya Priyam Dhanamarutya Prajatantum Mavivachetsi Satyana Pramaditavyam Dharmana Pramaditavyam Bhutyaina Pramaditavyam. Impression Banaki Narayana. So, you have to follow the do's and don'ts of life. Because you take this world as real. Like today when we were coming, I was talking to Prashant. I said, look here, we are sitting in the car. Both of us are sitting in the car. On whom are the traffic rules applied? On the driver or on the passenger? Think, both are sitting in the car in the same manner. Till such time, this world we take real, we want to drive. See? And then I am driving. Nothing wrong. Then follow the rules. So when we take these two principles together, one is taking this world as real and taking ourselves to be the doer, together we have to follow Dharma Shastra. Now what for it is done? It is done only for one purpose, that our mind is free from hang-ups. Then only we have no regrets in life. In the old days, most of the people suffer because of two things. Again, Taittiriya Upanishad says, Kimahagam papam akaravamiti, Kimahagam sadhuna akaravam. When I was young, why did I go the wrong way? Oh God, I should not have done that. And when I was young, why I did not do this? And therefore, if we have led a real dharmic life, how do we know whom you will ask? To ask yourself, are we carrying the burden of regrets of any kind? Regrets of wrong commissions and right omissions. Then we have cleaned or crossed the first hurdle, Adi Bhautik. In the language of Bhagavad Gita, Yoginaha Karma Kurvanti Sangam Tyaktva Atma Shuddhe. Live in this world in such a manner that don't allow any impressions to be precipitated on the mind, and then we carry that burden throughout our life. After that is done, then the second stage we come, Adi Daivik. Adi Daivik means what? Our whole life is spent only for one purpose. And that is unsuccessful attempts to fulfill our desires. Desires can never be fulfilled. You fulfill one desire, second is standing in the queue. What about me? See? And then our whole life is only fulfilling the desire, nothing else. And then when we fail to get it done, then we go to the Mahatmas. Mahatmaji, please see that my son is not getting married. You please tell him. One amma came and told me. I said, I will tell him never get married. No, but why don't you tell him? I said, look here, I failed to get myself married. My ashirwad will break that marriage. Don't bring it to me. See, friends. So all our efforts are going to the temple or going to the Mahatmas or anywhere only for fulfilling our desires. See, that is upasana. Now be attentive. Our upasana is complete or not, how do we know? Only one way. If upasana leads to inquiry, kastvam koham kutamayataha. When inquiry is kindled, then upasana is complete. So when these two things are done, adi bhavati karmani chitta shuddhyartham, adi daivi aikagryartham upasanam. Upasana is done, mind is fully available. Such a person is a qualified student for adhyatma, for the spiritual life. And this is what we have seen in these last few sentences, that sadhana chatushtaya sampanna adhikarinam ayam tattvabodha vidhiyate. So we assume we have these qualities. Now, to such a student, the inquiry continues. That atma kaha sthula sukshma karna sharira vidiriktaha pancha kosha titaha san avastatraya sakshi satchidananda swarupaha san yat tishtati sa atma. The meaning of the word atma is so much complicated. See? Atma means what? So when I say, I am old, here I, the Atma, means body. When I say, I am hungry, here the word I means pranamaya kosha. When I say, I am miserable, here I means mind. When I say, my children don't listen to me, here, I means the unfortunate parents. So many eyes. We are not one inside. We are a poultry farm. Cock, 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 cock. Going on and on and on. Come on, you decide which eye you are. See? So, what is the real meaning of Atma? Now here the teacher says, first of all, Sthula Shariram Kim. What is the meaning of the gross body? If you are a Gujarati, what is the meaning of gross body? So, Sthula Shariram Kim. Panchikruta pancha mahabhutaihi krutam satkarma janyam sukadukkhadi bhogayatanam shariram asti jayate varata viparinamate apakshiyate vinashyati iti shadvikaravat etas thulam shariram. Now what is said, panchikruta pancha mahabhutaihi krutam, that which is born out of the grossified five great elements. Grossification is a process by which the subtle is reduced to the gross. Be attentive. Subtle is always the cause and gross is always the effect. Subtle is always unknown, the gross is known. When we go to the doctor, we don't tell him the disease unless you are Indian. When the Indians go to the doctor, they say, Daksha, ek injection thok do yaar. Are, is it a nail to be nailed or what? So when we go to the doctor, we tell the symptoms. One person went to the doctor, Daksha, I get good sleep, I got good hunger, I don't get tensions, I am very free, I am very cheerful and happy. What is the reason? So, the doctor says, you are suffering from vitamin C deficiency. Vitamin C, S-H-E. When C will come in your life, everything will be leveled. So, we tell the symptoms. From the symptoms, we read the disease. So, here also, Panchikruta Mahabhutaihi means what? This gross world that we see, what is the world for us? Three factors. The inert world is everything what we see objectively. Second thing is the dynamism activity in the world. And the third is the knowledge aspect. Other than these three, there is nothing more than this. This is the world. So we ask, what is the cause of this inert world? We are told, the cause is tamoguna. And like any dumb, we agree, okay. Then we are told, what is the cause of dynamism? Why that man is so active? Rajoguna, acha rajoguna. Then, how come that man is so intelligent? Sattvaguna. And then we have that funny notion. Tamoguna is bad. Rajoguna is very uncomfortable. Sattvaguna is goody-goody. And then we start labeling the world. My husband is so tamoguni. This is the spiritual abuse. My children are very rajoguni. What about you? I am sattvaguni. Nobody has seen these three gunas. Nobody has seen. Then how they are established? From the effect, we reach the cause. So, sukshma is the cause and gross is the effect. So, this gross body is formed from the grossified five elements. And the grossification of the five elements is a very simple process. When they try to explain objectively, therefore I don't use any objective thing to explain. We are already lost in objectivity in our life. See? Then we try to understand, okay, pancha maha panchi karana, okay. Suppose these are the five elements. Now to indicate the element, you have to have some kind of drawing. So you draw an egg type thing. These are the five elements. Cut it half, cut. Then leave the upper one as it is. Okay. The lower one cut into four. Okay. Then the one part of the lower one goes to the remaining four. Okay. In this manner, each element has got half of its own and 1/8 of the remaining 4. This is how it is grossified. Now, when you understand this, okay, you make it. But space doesn't have anda. Get lost. So, grossification is a process by which things come to the cognition. So, panchikrita mahabhutaihi krutam satkarma janyam. And now, these 5 great elements come together and make this body. How this body is made is known by our people in Bombay on Chowpati, where they are selling the Bhelpuri. They make out of the thrown newspapers a cone. And in that they will be adding the 4 things. And then they will top it with the organic salt. And then you can eat it. Exactly the same thing Brahmaji did. In the container of the space, he mixed the 4 elements and moved it right. And then, and the body is born. Panchikrita Mahabhutaihi Satkarma Janyam Sukadukhadi Bhogayatanam. All the joy and sorrows are experienced in this body. Be attentive. All the joy and sorrows are experienced in this body, but not by the body. This is a basic thing, friends. Every experience happens only in the mind. No experience happens to the body. Body is inert. See, once in Narayan Hrudayalayam, Bangalore, they took me and wanted to take a round, so I took a round and they said, Swamiji, have you seen the heart operation? I said, no, I have not seen. Come, we'll show you. So I had to change my clothes and all that and I went. That patient was lying, he was on ventilators, everything. And the chest was open and the heart was like a deflated football bladder, flat. So I said, ye jaldi karo, mar jayega. He said, no, no, don't worry. Is he not having any pain? No, nothing. Then that friend man showed me, tak-tak, see, kuch nahi ho raha usko. Because experiences happen only to the mind. And the mind is expressing through the body. See. So, body is only ayatanam, a house. When I went to somebody's house, my friend Guptaji, you know, my all friends in the world are Guptaji. One person asked me this question. Swamiji, what is this? You have Guptaji here, from you caught him. I said, look here. Bhagwan Shankaracharya used to have Devadatta, Vishnudatta. Then our Osho was having Mulla Nasruddin. I said, I have discovered Guptaji. He said, where from you got Guptaji? Then I told, I said, once it happened, in Jhumkewala Bareli, I was going below a tree, there were some people playing chess and we were having a cup of tea. So I was watching like that. And they were sitting on a bench, both sides, like sitting on a horse, in the center of the chess board. This side 5-6 people, this side 5-6 people. And one person was telling, Are Gupta, hathi ko chala. Are Gupta, ghode ko chala. And that he was doing like that. And he won. So this person, he said, hey, who was telling? I was telling. But how do you know my name is Gupta? He said, main har ek bevakoof ko Gupta hi kehta. From that day onward, he became my character. He discovered Narayana. So, sukha dukkhadi bhogayatanam. So, when I go to somebody's house and I knock, And the maid servant opened the door. I said, hey, Guptaji, hey. No, Swamiji has gone out. But you come in. I said, what for I come? No, there is furniture, there are walls, there are windows, there is everything. Have I gone to see the furniture or what? In the same manner, experience is not by the body. Experience is in the body. Body is just a house. Ayatanam. So, sukadukkhadi bhogayatanam shariram. Shariram means what? Shiryamanatvat shariram. That which is subject to disintegration. When the body dies, nothing happens. See, the five elements go back to five elements. Yada panchavatishthante jnanani manasasa buddhishchana vicheshtate tamahu paramamgatim. According to yoga, this is what is called as realization. But this is not the ultimate. See? So here, the shariram shirya manatvan, it is disintegrated. How? And what is the shariram? Six aspects. First is asti, it is in the womb. Then jayate, then it is delivered. Then vardhate, then it starts growing vertically. Then viparinamate, then it starts growing horizontally. Then apakshiyate, then it becomes old. And vinashati, then it dies. So that thing which has the six aspect is called as sharira. You take anything which has got the six aspect, that is called a sharira, the body. See, friends. Therefore, the first step on the spiritual path is to know the body so that you can discard the body. Knowledge is, I have got two purposes. One purpose is know so that you can reject. And second, know so that you can assert. See. So, etat shad vikaravat sthula shariram. This which is associated with the six modifications is called as the gross body. See, these are the basic things. In a school, a child was learning in their KG1, KG2. So the teacher must have told, see, today I am going to teach you human body. This is head, this is neck, this is limbs, these are legs, okay? Now the child is equipped with the knowledge, goes home. Mummy, do you know what is gross, human body? Now the mother is a medical doctor. So she starts telling, yes, I know. There is a CNS system, there is a digestive system. You don't know anything. Why? That is not the gross human body. Then human body is that which has got a head, which has got a neck. Look here. Our condition is like that only. We are living. Be attentive. We are living as the body, for the body, on everybody. Start living through the body. See, when we start living through the body, then the body is not a burden for us. Today, our whole life is spent only taking care of, while taking food, organic water. Everywhere organic. And then worried about the figure. And all those who are wasting their life in figure, they have no figure. And what will you do by remaining in good figure? Marnathoy. No, but I want to die in a nice figure. Don't waste your time in that figure business. I'll tell you one thing. This is how I learned in my life. Once somebody died, we went to the crematorium. And that fellow was burning there on the pyre. One person asked me, Swamiji, how much time it will take? I said, come on, there, I don't have experience. See, people ask any question. He said, no, I can tell you. I said, then you know, I want to tell you. I said, tell me. He said, he will take maybe about 2.5 hours. I said, what is the parameter? He said, parameter is very simple. those who are fat, they have built-in fuel. So they burn quickly. And those who are only bony, 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 they have to put more and more lagdi and phir bhi nahi jalte. Therefore, for the posthumous comfort, be fat. This comes in the 19th chapter of Gita. You will never be miserable in life. All the time only figure, figure, figure. And these girls so useless, they are so much interested in figure that if a fly flies next to them, that the gush of the fly kicks them out. So thin. Don't be pampered brand. Now, what is the sukshma shariram? Apanchi krita maha bhutaihi kritam sat karma janyam sukha dukkhadi bhoga sadhanam panche jnanendriyani pancha karmendriyani pancha pranadaya manashaikam buddhi shaika evam saptadasha kalabihi sahayat tishtati tat sukshma shariram. See. Now, what is the subtle body? Some people say subtle body. Never mind. So, what is the subtle body? Apanchi krita maha bhutaihi kritam. Now, see. The gross body was made out of the panchikrita, grossified five elements. Now the subtle body is made out of ungrossified, nascent five great elements. And mahabhutaihi kritam satkarma janya, as a result of your karma, then what is this? Sukha dukkhadi bhoga sadhanam. All experiences happen in the mind. If the mind is not involved, you have zero experience. See, I learned this in some place I had in Bombay only. On my right toe, there was some kind of growth, like a strawberry type of growth. Some red was growing. So one of person did namaskar. He said, Swami, what is happening here? I said, that is a wisdom toe I am growing. He said, don't do that. It is risky. I said, okay, I'll go to the doctor. He said, no, I am doctor. I can sort it out. I said, okay, I went with him. He made me sit in the chair, put my leg on the stool, gave local anesthesia. And then he said, okay, you can watch now. And then he took the scalpel, cut it. The blood was coming. I saw that. He put the scalpel deep inside and took it out. And I saw everything, but no pain. Why? Because the toe was in chemical meditation. See? This is what these dentist people do. They'll be bringing the driller. Kar, 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 kar. Those people who are seeing, they feel, oh God, but this man whose mouth is open, he can't even close. Even then, he doesn't get the pain because that area is in meditation. See, recognize this principle. Every experience happens only in mind. But we never mind our mind. What care we have taken about our mind? About the body? Oh God, there is no end to it. See? And the worst part is, there are two aspects of our body which are dead. One is hair. And second is nails. And maximum money is spent on the nail hair spa. And they will be going and sitting there. And they like this. And the lady will and when they have to eat curry, they can't eat. Useless. So, sukha dukkhadi bhoga sadhanam, pancha jnanendriyani, five sense organs, five organs of action, five pranas, mana buddhi, eka, evam, sapta dashakala bihisah. So, thus, 17 things, five jnanendriya plus five karmendriya 10, plus five prana 15, mind and intellect 17. These 17 factors together is called as the subtle body. Now be attentive. Anything which is made of the components, it is not real. See, today I went to somebody's house for lunch. There was a sweet little child, and he had so plastic blocks. So he was making this thing, that thing, sometime train, sometime engine, sometime flight, something like that. So they are made out of the components. When you remove the component, where it has gone? Nowhere. Exactly the same way. That which is made out of the components, like your car. The car is made out of so many components. But the car is not meant for any of the components. The car is not meant for the steering. The car is not meant for the wheels. Then it is meant for the owner of the car. Exactly the same way. We are not the mind. The mind is meant for me. See? But what happens? The mind rules us. Therefore, when we become clear about it, that real spiritual practice begins when you start working on your mind. Samsara begins when you start working on your gross body. Whole life is spent only on gross body. Once I was traveling from Washington DC to Sao Paulo in Argentina, very long flight, 14 hours. And two seats. So I usually sit near the window. You can sometimes look outside, jump outside, whatever. So on. And I expected that nobody will come, then I can relax. But one Chinese girl came and sat. And then after the whatever they have to give for eating, we ate. And then immediately she took out her whole thing and started putting patches on her face and those cucumber cut pieces on her eyes and meditation. How much all the time body. There is much more than that in life. See, therefore, this body is a container, and in this container, mind is expressed, but mind is not inside the body. Like bulb is the container in which light is expressed, but light is not limited inside the bulb. Light is both inside and outside. Don't we have the experience of outside world through the same mind, and inside world, pet mein dard ho raha hai. Who knows? The same mind. See, friends, in this manner, slowly break the concept that we are inside the body. It is for this purpose we are told. We are by default expert in blaming others for all that happens to us. So the spiritual practice is, stop blaming others and be responsible for your life. Then, like, you know, one husband came and told me, Swamiji, why other people get good wives? I got such a terrible one. Please tell me what I should do. So I told him, look here, first of all, stop complaining. In the last life, you have tortured her. Therefore, she was doing Karma Chauth. Now she will not live for 7 lives. Jaoge kaha? Now what I should do? Now behave properly with her. Otherwise, next life, guarantee. What will happen? You will stop complaining and you will start behaving properly. And be attentive. You will be responsible for your life. The day this happens, we are responsible for our life. Nobody is responsible. See? So, these 17 factors put together is, in simple language, called as the mind, In technically, it is called the subtle body or the sukshma sharira, linga deha, etc. Now, what are the five dhanendriyas, karmendriyas? They are simply enumerated. You are all expert. You know about it. Shrotram, tvak, chakshur, sana, grahana, mithi, pancha, dhanendriyani, shrotrasya, devat, dig devata, tacho, vayuhu, chakshushaha, surya, rasanaya, varunaha, grahanasya, ashvino, iti, dhanendriya, devata, shrotrasya, vishaya, shabda, grahanam, tacho, vishaya, sparsha, grahanam, chakshusho, vishaya, rupa, grahanam, rasanaya, vishaya, rasa, grahanam, grahanasya, vishaya, gandha, grahanam, iti. Now be attentive. Everything has to be understood in these three aspects: structural, functional, and who is the owner of that structure and function. Structural is adi bhautik, functional is adi daivik, and owner is adhyatmik. All the mantras have got three aspects. See, so initially the students learn only adi bhautik, structural aspect. Then when we grow a little bit in our understanding, then we come to the functional aspect. And then when we still grow further, we come to the subjective aspect. It is something like this. A simple example. For the first time, when the mother is taking the book to read and doing, keeping the book little away, bringing near, so the children tell, "Mom, what is this style you are doing these days? Like this, why don't you keep in one place and read?" "No, my darling, I can't see properly, and therefore my eyes are not functioning properly. Earlier, I was looking at the book. Now, although I am looking at the book, my attention is on the functioning of the book, of the eyes." See? So first, we are lost in the objective world. Then from the objective world, we come to the experiences of the world. "I am so depressed, so dejected. What should I do?" Everything is there. All comforts and comfortably miserable. All luxuries, luxuriously miserable. See? All food and starving miserable. See, friends. Thus, first we are lost in the objective world, then we come to the subjects. Now you look at your own body. When you get married for the first time, we have to make that clause, Then you'll be going here and there collecting all the rubbish. And husband will say, "Why do you carry all this?" No, you don't have any aesthetic sense. We should have this thing to hang here, hang there. And now your house is so full of all garbage, rubbish. See? Now you don't even look at it. I remember one South Indian house. They had a huge Lord Shiva, in the dancing posture. And they have near the door a small katori where there is vibhuti. So they don't have to take bath also. When coming out, they just take little vibhuti, put it here, so the world knows that you have taken bath. Makeup is complete. So when we are going, that katori was not there. So he shouted, "Hey, where is that? I had to put on vibhuti, I had to go out." Then there, Shivaji was standing like this. So from his hand, I put my finger like this and moved like this. I said, "Here is the vibhuti." Not even touched that for last 20 years. But we'll not give it to anybody. Keep on accumulating. First, adi bhautik, then adi daivik. "No, Swamiji, my children are going to school and college and they are not studying. What I should do? They are your children. How can they study?" So, adi bhautik, adi daivik. And then we come to the adhyatmik. Therefore, these three things. So the five dhanendriyas, then the adi devi, shrotrasya devata, dig devata. So the structural eye is adi bhautik. Functional eye is dig devata. Tvacho vayuhu, the presiding deity for the tvacha, the skin, is the Vayu, Chakshushaha, Surya. The presiding deity for the vision is the sun. Rasanayaha, Varunaha. The presiding deity for the taste, the rasana, is Varuna. And Granasya, Ashvinav. So Ashvinav Kumaras, they are the presiding deities of the nose. These are the Jnanendriya Devata. Then respective objects where they function. The ears are in the Shabda Granam. Be attentive. Shrotrasya Vishaya Shabda Grana. Shabda, sound. It doesn't matter whether it is the Lord's name or it is an abuse. It doesn't matter whether it is a discourse or a disco. They are all heard by the same ears. Rupa Grahanam Chakshusha, by the eyes, any form, any color, doesn't matter what form, what color is there. Go to the base. See, then we will come to know we are not attached to anybody or anything by default. Attachment is an illusion. If eyes are attached to a particular color, then that eyes will not see any other color. But eyes are illuminating every color. If the ears are attached to any particular sound, then the ears will refuse to listen to any sound. But the ears hear every sound. Because the ears are only functioning to listen to the sound. Doesn't matter what sound it is. See, friends, in this manner, the various sense organs are functioning in the respective field. Similarly, about the karmendriyas. Vak, pani, pada, payu, pasthaniti, pancha karmendriyani. And vacho devata vanni haste hastayoho indraha padayor vishnu mrityor payoho mrityu upasthasya prajapatihi iti karmendriya devata vacho vishayak bhashanam panyor vishayak vastu grahanam padayor vishayak gamanam payor vishayak malatyaga upasthasya vishaya ananda iti. The five, say, organs of action, they are the hands, legs, they hands, then first is vak, is speech. Speech, then hands, legs, then organ of excretion and organ of procreation. These are the five karmendriyani. And the respective devata, presiding deity, the functional aspect is the fire, Indra, Vishnu, death and Prajapati. And their respective functional areas are vacho vishaya bhashanam. So the speech is organ of action, it talks. Then panyor vishaya vastu grahanam, the hands are meant for holding things. Padayo vishaya gavanam, by the legs we keep on moving. Payor vishaya malatyagaha, the organ of excretion are meant for throwing the excreta from the body. And upasthasya vishaya anandaiti, and procreation, the subject or the object is the ananda, the bliss. In this manner, these are the five Jnanendriyas, Karmendriyas. Now see. Thereafter, the teacher takes up next one is the Karana Shariram Kim. What is the causal body? So be very attentive. When we are told gross body, we get a kind of a image in our mind. Body means this has got this particular shape. Then subtle body, this also we are able to appreciate. That subtle body is pervading the whole gross body, so it also has a shape. But when it comes to the causal body, the Karan Sharira, there most of the people get lost. Causal body is not a shape. See, then what is the causal body, Karan Sharira? Anirvachya Anadi Avidya Rupam Sharira Dvayasya Karana Matram Sat Swarupa Jnanam Nirvikalpaka Rupam Yadastati Yadasti Tat Karana Shariram. Now be attentive. What is the causal body? Anirvachya. It cannot be defined. Can we define light? Yes. This much power, that much power. Can we define darkness? What is the reason? Darkness is absence of light. So how can you define absence? Is absence an object? See, anirvachya cannot be defined in terms of this or that. Like we have defined gross body made out of the grossified five elements, subtle body made out of the ungrossified five elements, it has got these components. In the same manner, causal body cannot be defined in terms of the components or the size, etc. Therefore, anirvachya, understand this is a very subtle important point. Second is avidya rupam. See, avidya means what? Most of the people translate avidya or ajnana means absence of knowledge. Knowledge can never be absent. Then what is avidya or ajnanam or ignorance? Ignorance means incomplete knowledge. Do you know Gujarati? No, I don't know. So you don't know this, you know, is it not? Yes. Then how are you ignorant? Knowledge can never be absent. Then what is creating the problem? Be very attentive. Vedanta is not complete unless you bring the snake and the rope. Whether you know Brahman or not doesn't matter. You must know the snake and the rope. And what for the snake and the rope example? The snake is meant for the disciples to be beaten so that the disciples die. And when the disciples die, what the guru will do? So the rope is meant for the guru to hang himself. And both of them are liberated from each other. So, if you do not know at all, there will be no problem. See? Like in deep sleep, we do not know anything. Where is the problem? Problem is for others, those who are sleeping next to us. Because our siren continues. Krrr, krrr. And hey, why are you snoring? No, I am not snoring. And again continues saptaswara. So, in utter ignorance, there is no samsara. In absolute wisdom, there is no samsara. See? Those who are halfway, there are many people in their heart of their heart, they had a desire to be doctors. But because of the pressure of the parents, they became softy or engineer, something like that. And when that doctor was still, you know, vibrant in their heart, when they retire, then they take the homeopathic books and they read. And one thing they catch it. And then they go out in their village. Hey, Guptaji, how are you? Everything is fine at home. Nobody is ill. They say, no, sab theek. Nobody is ill. No, nobody is ill. His knowledge is going west. He is finding a victim. See? नक्स भूमिक अथॉरिटी इसको ले लो बट कुछ हुआ ही नहीं हो जाएगा सो व्हेन यू हैव हाफ नॉलेज व्हेन यू हैव गॉट इनकम्प्लीट नॉलेज देन द संसार इज क्रिएटेड देयरफॉर व्हाट इज दिस कारण शरीरम अनिर्वाच्य इट कैनॉट बी एक्सप्लेन एंड अविद्या रूपम. Because we do not know something fully, be attentive. Our mind starts projecting something which is not there. Be attentive. Mind has two functions. One is perception. Second is projection. If we halt at perception and don't go to the next step of projection, there is no samsara. See the boys and the girls. How many boys and girls they see? Thousands and millions. But out of that, one Dumbo they catch hold of. I think she is meant for me. Otherwise, why she has come here? This was God's grace. God has got better things to do. See? So the mind starts projecting thereafter. And the projection becomes so strong that the mind gathers a momentum. And then the mind cannot think about anything except that stupid girl. And thereafter, the sukshma sharir is born. Then, jau to jau ka. Sukshma sharir. And then the sthula sharir is born. Start working. I should go and meet her father, and I had to tell my mother also. One South Indian boy and North Indian girl, they fell in love. And the South Indian boy told his mother, "Mummy, I want to get married to her." Mother, a South Indian, very strong. She said, "If you marry with that girl, you will have to walk on my dead body." A threatening. And he said, "Then it will be too late, Mama. You are not going to die early. I'll become very old by then." See? So, avidya kama karma. Because we have incomplete knowledge that leads to desire, and when we are functioning under the influence of the desire, karma is born. This is how this karan sharira is the cause for the subtle body desire and karma the gross body. Therefore, anirvachya avidya rupam sharira dvayasya karana matram swarupa ajnanam. We don't know ourselves. See? And because of that, we are constantly desiring and constantly struggling. Because we have refused to learn from our experiences. Our experiences clearly tell us that whenever you are living at zero desire level, you are happy. Like in deep sleep. If you have got one desire, and with that one desire, go to sleep, your whole night will be disturbed. For example, you have to catch the early morning flight. So you plan, let me finish the dinner quickly, then I'll go to sleep, then I'll get up at 2 o'clock, finish bath, become fresh, and put all the Begon spray, and thereafter, I go to the airport. So the earlier part we do, finish the dinner quickly, and then go to sleep, and after every 2 seconds, that one desire to catch the flight destroys our whole life, is it not? We have got Himalayan desires, whole life is destroyed. Spirituality means freedom from desires. Those people who are promising you fulfillment of desires, they are your enemies. See, friends, meditation is not sitting silently for half an hour and thereafter suffering violently the whole day. No, Bhagavan Krishna says, Prajahati yada kaman sarvan parthamanogatan atmanne vatmana tushtaha stita prajna sadochade. Our wisdom should be steady, not the body. See, simply body is steady, our buffaloes are very steady in their city. Even if a truck comes in front of them, they don't get disturbed. On the contrary, they look at them and with a chewing gum in the mouth, so what? Go there. You don't need disturb. And we sit for meditation and little bit disturbed here and there. We become so angry. See? Mummy sits in the morning for meditation. And then they, with great difficulty, everybody is sleeping, so she sits for meditation. And then in the bathroom, on the plastic bucket, the water drops one by one. Tuck, oh God, these children are so tuck. They don't understand the what tuck. With every tuck, her BP increases. And after a few tucks, the water drop stops. Again worry. Pani gaya? Meditation or cartoon of meditation? See, friends, steadiness of body has nothing to do. Wisdom should be steady. And how the wisdom is steady? Only two principles Bhagavan told. Prajahati yada kaman sarvan partha manogatan. Manogatan sarvan kaman yada prajahati. When we entertain zero desires. What is the meaning of entertaining zero desires? No complaints about anything or anybody. Is it a depression? No, it is not a depression. Then, atmane vatmana tushta. One is at peace with oneself. Therefore, here, anirvacha avidya rupam sharinadvaisa karana madram satsvarupa adhyanam nirvikalpaka rupam. Be attentive. Your and my gross bodies are separate. Our lives are separate. You know our lives. Samsari hoke nahi roya. Aur babaji hoke nahi soya. To kya kiya? So you are here to suffer. I am here to celebrate. So my life, gross body life, and your life is different. Agreed. My dreams and your dreams are different. Your dream is the student, the son is not studying, what I should do. My dream is what? I am giving lecture and everybody is sleeping. So our gross life is separate, dream life is separate, but our causal body is one. We all come out of the same karan sharira. They are not different. Like waves are different. Their fate is different. But all of them come out of the same ocean. Because in deep sleep, in karan sharira, there is no sense of limited existence. And there is no sense of otherness. And there is no sense of limited existence and otherness. Where is the difference between you and me? See, friends, in the deep sleep experience, man is not man, woman is not woman, doggy is not a doggy. Kutta is a resort for human beings. You call somebody's doggy as kutta, they get angry. Army can't be. Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. So, nirvikalpaka rupam. There is no vikalpa. In the dream and waking, there are only vikalpa object, the options. Yadasari tat karanam shariram. That is what is called as the causal body. Now the next question is raised. Avasthatrayam kim? Avasthatraya sakshi san. That was said. So, jagra sapna sushupti avasthaha. There are three experiences. This is the gift of Vedanta, that all our experiences must be totally analyzed. See, friends, when we write autobiography of a Dumbo, we refer only to the waking experiences. We don't include dream and deep sleep. It is something like trying to arrive at the conclusion by incomplete data. Because statistical analysis, keep the head of a person in the hot air oven and the feet in the deep freeze, average temperature is normal. See, friends. That is how the autobiographies are written. I was born there. I was going, when are you born? Somebody tells you are born, you agreed. See, once in my life I went to a maternity hall, and after whatever I had to do, I finished. Then I said, Mama, my job is over. That is my friend. She wanted to know. Now I just want to know, when you people tell somebody is born such and such time, if you observe, nobody is born on a round figure. You see anybody's patrika? 9:37. 9:37. Are you holding the stopwatch? Kab aaya, kab gaya, kab aaya, kab gaya. And it's not only one, there are dozens of them standing in a queue. And when the head comes or tail comes, how do you know? So she says, how shall I tell you the truth? If we tell them round figure, somebody is born at 8 o'clock, they will not believe us. 7:59, ah, 50. And on the basis of that, we make patrika. And then ganas, you know, rakshasa gana. अजोपि सन्नव्यात्मा भूतानां ईश्वरोपि सन् प्रकृतिं स्वामधिष्ठाय संभवाम्यत्वमायया. Never are we born, friends. Don't get carried away by all that rubbish. So, avastha, jagra, svapna, sushupti. If we want to really understand our life, we have to take into account all the three kinds of experience. If we take only waking and neglect the other two, we are partial. We are not scientifically oriented in our analysis. So what is the Jagradavastha? Jagradavastha ka Shrotradi Jnanendriya Shabdadi Vishaischa Jnayati Iti Yasa Jagradavastha Stula Sharira Vyamani Atma Vishod Iti Uchate. Now, what is the waking state? When through the sense organs, we come in contact with the sense object, and that experience is called as the waking experience. And in this waking experience, the speech that I am using is called as the Vaikari Vani. It is not mentioned here, but it is Vaikari Vani. Vaikari means what? Parashruti Gochara. When I am talking to you, you are able to hear. So that experience where objects are different from the sense organs, that experience where the subject-object differentiation is distinct and clear, that experience is called as the Jagratavastha, the waking, and the one who is thus identified with the gross body, he is called as Vishwa. This is the Atma called as Vishwa. So the self identified with the gross body is Vishwa. Like the man identified with the wife is called as husband. Now the next one. What is Svapnavastha Keti Chet? Jagradavasthayam yad drushtam yad shrutam tad janita vasanaya nidra samaye yaha prapancha pratiyate sa Svapnavastha sukshma sharira bhivani atma tajasi iti uchyate. Now, what is the Svapnavastha? Jagrat avasthayam yad srutam yad drishtam tad janita vasanayaha. See, when we are leading our day-to-day waking life, then what happens? So many impressions are created on our mind, and those deep impressions which did not find expression in the waking experience, those impressions become manifest in the dream. I am an ordinary clerk in an office, and my officer is always torturing me. So I am frustrated, but I can't do anything. I don't know what to do. And with that frustration, I go to sleep. And then in the dream, I dream. I am the boss. My boss is my servant. I shout at him, get a glass of water for me. Sir, 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 sir. He brings it. You stupid, get away. Who asked you to go down? And I tried to fulfill my desires, which I could not do in the waking, in the dream. See, friends, dreams are nothing but the impressions which are formed on the mind, they are exhibited. Be attentive. again, learn from your experiences. I'll tell you my how I learned one particular thing. This happened in England. I reached in the evening to Heathrow, London, and then one of my friend, a Britisher, he came to pick me up, and I was going to one ashram in Wales. When we were going about 4 hours, 5 hours drive. So evening 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, I landed. So it was getting late. So meanwhile, he called his mother just to inform her. Then the mother said, if your Swami has no problem, he can come and stay here tonight. Next day you go. Why will you drive all the way at night, another 2-3 hours? So I said, I have no problem. So I went to their house. And if you want to see an ideal, beautiful house, go to a Britisher's house. They are so neat and perfect, unlike the Indian houses. Indian houses, you can see, smell, taste from a distance. All the Panchamahabhutas are there in a terrible form. See? No clean house you can see. So, after the formalities, there was a nice bed and nice table and some books kept. And when I took some book reading after some time, then I said, now I have to sleep. So put the book down. I wanted to switch off the lights. I could not see where is the switch. So I had to get up again and saw the switch. So when I saw the switch, the light was so bright as if it has entered my eyes. Very bright light, very look like that. Then I switch off and lie down. When I'm closing my eyes, I could see those bright lights with the closed eyes. When I open my eyes, I could see the street lights. Again, I closed my eyes, I was seeing the bright light. And Eureka! Who am I? The one who is illuminating the waking world and the one who is illuminating the dream world is the common factor without becoming a waker and without becoming a dreamer. That is the real me. See, my friends, waking comes and goes. Dream comes and goes. You are the same. See, who can make this statement? I had good sleep, but in between I had bad dreams. Who can make this statement? Waker cannot make this statement because Waker was not in the dream. Waker was not in the deep sleep. Then who makes this statement? The one who is in the waking without becoming a waker, who has illuminated the dream without becoming a dreamer, and who has illuminated the deep sleep without going to sleep. सर्वस्य चाहं हृदि सन्निमिष्टः मत्तः स्मृति ज्ञानम् अपोहनं च वेदैश्च सर्वै अहमेव वेद्यः. I alone support ज्ञानम् waking, स्मृति dream, अपोहनम् deep sleep, चकारात् समाधि. I alone support all these four kinds of experiences. This I, सर्वैः वेदैः अहमेव वेद्यः. All the scriptures are meant for recognizing who is this I. Then the Tattvabodha happens. Who has experienced the childhood? And where the child has gone? Who has experienced the teenage? Where the teenage body has gone? Who has experienced the middle age, where that body has gone? Who is experiencing the old age? Let this body go, who cares? When earlier three bodies have gone, we didn't care. Why care for one dilapidated body? Marne bhi nahi dete. See, friends, this is the purpose of studying Tattvabodha. Otherwise, we simply are the information. Swapnavastha, keti, change, jagratavastha, is only information. It has to be applied every moment in our life. So, tajjanita vasanaya nidra samaya yah prapanchaha pratiyate. So, whatever is recorded on the mind, that alone we see. Even doesn't it happen during the day also or night? Only impressions come up. If your mind carries no impression, you are realized. Mind without impressions is consciousness. Consciousness with impressions is mind. What simpler definitions you want? Man with the burden of wife is husband. Husband unloading the burden of wife is man. Can we separate the man and husband from each other? No. So between the two, husband and man, who is reality? Man is the real. Husband is an illusion. So what is to be done? Recognize the illusion as an illusion and relax. One day, a person went home and knocked the door. Suddenly, he lifted his wife both the hands and going toward the dining table. Wife said, "Hey, what happened to you today? You are coming from satsang. Swamiji was romantic or what?" "No," he told, "you must carry your burden." Relax. Spirituality is not seriousness. Otherwise, spirituality, many times, as if you have eaten a handful of caterpillar. Spirituality, oh my, right? That is not the way. Relax. You are not going to get anything. Tyage naike amritatva manasya. So, yad prapancha pratiyate sa svapnavastha stukshma sharira bhimanya atma taijasa ucchate. So, the gross body identified self is called as Vishwa. The one and when identified with the subtle body is called a Taijasa. Like the same man identified with the father is called as son, identified with the wife is called as husband. Be attentive. Son is not husband. The man is the husband. The waker is not the dreamer. The pure self alone. With the conditioning of the gross body identification, he is called as the waker. Then the same pure reality, self, with the conditioning of the subtle body, he is called as the dreamer. Waker never becomes dreamer. Most of the students get lost here. See, friends. And then they get lost so much. We'll go further probably in this, it must be there. Tattvamasi Mahavakyopane, there this is brought out beautifully. Now, atha sushupti avastha ka. Now, what is the sushupti avastha? Aham kimapi na janami sukhe namaya nidra anubhuyata iti sushupti avastha karana sharira abhimani atma prajna iti ucchate. Now, what is the sushupti avastha, the deep sleep state? In that state, now see here, it is not mentioned anything. Only aham kimapi na janami, a state of not knowing anything. See? I don't know who am I don't know what is the world, I don't know what is God, I don't know nothing. A state of utter ignorance, but I know I am. See? Therefore, aham kimapi na janami sukhena maya nidra anubhuyate, but I am experiencing the bliss, and therefore after we get out of the sleep, maybe 4 hours, 8 hours, nobody ever says, "Come on yaar, I was sleeping for 8 hours, I am damn tired now." No, because for 8 hours you are soaked in bliss. It is like, you know, charging your phone when you go to sleep, put it for charging. Next day morning you get up, it is fully charged. Because your small battery was connected with the total power supply. In the same manner, our useless mind was merged in the absolute reality. Ahar ahar brahma gamayati, Prashnopanishad says. In the deep sleep, we merge back in the pure consciousness. Therefore, sleep, even in satsanga, doesn't matter. That is why those who sleep, I like them very much. Sleeping is such a good hobby which doesn't cost you anything. You don't need a company. And you don't get disturbed. You may disturb others, never mind. That is called a realization. Bhagavad Gita also says, Yanisha sarva bhutanam tasyam jagrati sayami. Yasyam jagrati bhutani sa nisha pashyato munehe. Wise people sleep when others are awake. Narayana. So, sukhena maya nidra anubhuyate iti sushupti avastha and karana sharira bhivani atma pragya iti uchyate. Now see, the example, man is called as the son, husband and father. Similarly, the self is called as Vishwa, when identified with the body, what we call in English as Vekar. Then, Tejasa, when identified with the subtle body, what we call as Dreamer. Then, Prajna, when identified with the Karan Sharira, that is called as what we call Deep Sleeper. So it is the same Paramatma with the three conditioning, is referred in three ways, but he has not become three. And these three fellows, the son, the husband and the father, they are miserable. See friends, when my father died, where I, the son, has gone? When my wife disappeared, where I, the husband, has gone? When my son disappeared, where I, the father, has gone? Nowhere. Because they were never anywhere. And these non-existing entities, they are miserable. How can you help them? Our struggle is like the bird looking into the mirror and trying to sort out all the accounts with him. I'll teach you a lesson. To whom will you teach? See, my friends, once we recognize this truth, then life is a great fun. And when life is great fun, only you are at peace. You will never like to improve anybody. Will you like to improve the image in the mirror? You need not. And you cannot. So try these two principles. Number one, never try to make anybody happy. But you know, paropakarartham satam vibhutaya, it is said, we should do good to others and suffer. No one try to make anybody happy. But why? We belong to democracy. Everybody has the right to be miserable. This I learned again from you people only. One day my friend was driving me and he told me, Swamiji, see that taxi fellow's door is open. I'll take it parallel and you tell him to close it. So I had to listen. I am Swami for namesake. I had to listen to everybody. So he made the car parallel and I told, hey Mahatmaji, your door is open. Close it. You will fall down. Apna kaam karo. Take care of yourself. When he said like that, my friend God says, see how useless. He's not useless, he's my guru. Why you bother in somebody else's life? Take care of yourself.
na prushtaha kasyachit bruyat na cha anyayena cha pruchyatah janan api medhavi jadaval lokam acharet.
If somebody doesn't ask, don't poke your nose anywhere. Keep away. They jadaval lokam acharet. And this is what I have learned from my gurus in United States. They are the NRI children. You ask anything to the NRI child. They like the Gayatri Mantra. There are three Vyahrutis. Om, Bhur, Bhur, Swaha. That is not Gayatri Mantra. Gayatri Mantra begins from Tatsavidurvarendyam Bhargo Devase Dhyame Dhyo Yona Prachodaya. First, you have to add these three Vyahrutis. Om, Bhur, Bhur, Swaha. In the same manner, you are the NRI children. Hey, what do you want to become after your schooling? Vyahruti. A, O, E, mantra. I don't know. It is such a maha mantra. Anybody asks you anything, I take care of, I take shelter of this mantra. A, O, I don't know. Everything is over. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.